Lord be with you.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ saith: Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it: Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. O Lord, raise up, we pray thee, thy power, and come among us, and with great might succor us, that whereas through our sins and wickedness we are sore let and hindered in running the race that is set before us, thy bountiful grace and mercy may speedily help and deliver us, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty God, give us grace that we may cast away the works of darkness and put upon us the armor of light, now in the time of this mortal life in which thy Son, Jesus Christ, came to visit us in great humility, that in the last day, when he shall come again in his glorious majesty to judge both the quick and the dead, we may rise to the life immortal, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray. O Lord, O God Almighty, we beseech thee to keep us thy servants both outwardly in our bodies and inwardly in our souls, that by the glorious intercession of Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, we may be delivered from our present heaviness and attain in the end to us everlasting gladness. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to him with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end.
Amen.
The epistle is written in the fourth chapter of the Philippians, beginning in the fourth verse. Rejoice in the Lord always. And again I say, rejoice. Let your moderation be known unto all men. The Lord is at hand. Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Here endeth the epistle.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The Holy Gospel is written in the first chapter of the Gospel according to St. John, beginning at the 19th verse.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
This is the record of John. When the Jews sent priests and Levites from Jerusalem to ask him, "Who art thou?" And he confessed and denied not, but confessed, "I am not the Christ." And they asked him, "What then? Art thou Elias?" And he saith, "I am not. Art thou that prophet?" And he answered, "No." Then said they unto him, "Who art thou? That we may give an answer to them that sent us. What sayest thou of thyself?" He said, "I am the voice of one crying in the wilderness, Make straight the way of the Lord, as the prophet Esaias." And they which were sent were of the Pharisees, and they asked him and said unto him, Why baptizest thou then, if thou be not that Christ, nor Elias, neither that prophet? John answered them, saying, I baptize with water, but there standeth one among you whom ye know not. He it is who coming after me is preferred before me, whose shoes latchet, I am not worthy to unloose. These things were done in Bethabara beyond Jordan, where John was baptizing.
Praise be to thee, O Christ. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things are made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary and was made man and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures and ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord and giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe one Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
At first blush, there seems to be little connection between today's epistle and gospel. But I think that connection can be found by examining in some detail the circumstances underlying the call of John the Baptist to be the voice of one crying in the wilderness. The role of John the Baptist is so important in God's plan of salvation that God foretold John's coming hundreds of years before his birth. And he did so not once, but twice. In the 8th century BC, the prophet Isaiah first wrote of this promised messenger, comfort ye my people, saith your God. Speak ye comfortably to Jerusalem, and cry unto her that her warfare is accomplished, that her iniquity is pardoned. For she hath received of the Lord's hand double for all her sins. The voice of him that crieth in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Isaiah chapter 40, which by the way is part of today's daily office reading. Conspicuously absent from this prophecy is any time frame for the appearing of the voice in the wilderness. Of course, Isaiah did not live to see this prophecy fulfilled, and it lay dormant for 300 years until it appeared again in the 5th century BC. Speaking through the prophet Malachi, God once again proclaimed, Behold, I will send my messenger, and he shall prepare the way before me. And the Lord whom ye seek shall suddenly come to his temple. Malachi chapter 3, which was last evening's daily office reading. Again, Malachi's prophecy contained no time frame for its fulfillment. So another 400 years went by before God, in the fullness of time, sent his angel, Gabriel, to announce the beginning of the prophecy's fulfillment in approximately 6 BC. The account of how God did this is found in chapter 1 of Luke's gospel, and it contains so many wonderful details that we could spend hours going over them. We won't do that this morning. But I do want to spend a little time reviewing the key details, many of which will be familiar to you. Zechariah and Elizabeth were an aged, childless couple who lived in the days of King Herod. They were part of a righteous remnant of Jews, and Zechariah was a priest who periodically served in the temple in Jerusalem. On one of his tours in the temple, Zechariah was chosen by lot to enter into the temple to burn incense. While he was inside the temple, the angel Gabriel appeared and announced that Zechariah's persistent prayers for a son had been answered. Gabriel announced that the son would be filled with the Holy Ghost, even from his mother's womb, and that his mission in life would be to make ready for the Lord a people prepared. Zechariah was temporarily stricken dumb because he expressed doubt about what Gabriel had told him. But as Gabriel had promised, Elizabeth did indeed conceive a son, although she kept herself hidden from public view for a while. About 6 months later, the angel Gabriel then appeared to the Virgin Mary and announced that she too would conceive a son, but this time by the Holy Spirit, not by a natural father. Shortly afterwards, Mary, now pregnant herself, visited her cousin Elizabeth. Upon arrival at Elizabeth's house, the baby in Elizabeth's womb, that is John, leaped for joy when Mary greeted her. Elizabeth proclaimed to Mary, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb." And Mary responded with one of the most famous passages in the Bible, the Magnificat. "My soul doth magnify the Lord, and my spirit hath rejoiced in God my Savior." This canticle is so beautiful and full of meaning that we recite it every day at evening prayer. After staying with Elizabeth for about 3 months, Mary then returned home. Meanwhile, the fact of Elizabeth's pregnancy had finally become public, and her neighbors and relatives rejoiced with her. After the baby was born, Zechariah wrote on a tablet that the baby should be named John, as Gabriel had prescribed. And immediately Zechariah regained his voice, whereupon he recited the famous canticle known as the Song of Zechariah, which begins, "Blessed be the Lord God of Israel, for he hath visited and redeemed his people." Like the Magnificat, this important canticle is also recited in the daily offices during morning prayer. Luke concludes his lengthy narrative as follows. "And the child grew and became strong in spirit, and he was in the wilderness until the day of his public appearance in Israel." So, when John claims in today's gospel that he is, in fact, the voice of one crying in the wilderness, we, unlike most of his contemporaries, know the entire backstory, thanks to Luke's diligent research. And John certainly knew all of this through his parents. Luke's account shows that John's claim was supported by a virtual cloud of signs and wonders, and that he was neither a misguided zealot nor a lunatic. I believe this is one reason why Paul encourages us so emphatically to rejoice always. As a self-described Hebrew of Hebrews and an expert in the law, Philippians chapter 3, Paul would have seen this and other prophecies fulfilled in the days of John and Jesus as unassailable guarantees of God's providence, the truth of the gospel, and solid ground for casting out every hint of doubt and anxiety. In saying that we should rejoice always, Paul certainly did not mean that Christians should constantly be doing a sort of happy dance. If that were the case, I would be doomed, because I really don't like to dance. Rather, our rejoicing finds its foundation in a calm, certain, and enduring knowledge that God's promises are always reliable, that Christ will always, in the words of the collect, speedily help and deliver us, especially when we are sore let and hindered in running the race that is set before us. In this last week of Advent, we are tempted to skip ahead in our meditations to Luke chapter 2, the account of the birth of Jesus. Instead, stay grounded in Luke chapter 1. Carefully read and reflect on all the truth and beauty contained in that carefully documented account of the birth of John the Baptist. Reacquaint yourself with those powerful and beautiful canticles, the Song of Zechariah and the Magnificat, and you will see why they are such an important part of the daily offices. Finally, considering that the Lord is at hand, as Paul reminds us, take heed to the wise and practical instruction contained in today's epistle. Commit it to memory this week. Make it part of your daily routine, preferably when you rise in the morning, to recite those four magnificent verses aloud and commit yourself daily to living by them. Why not experience the peace of God, which passeth all understanding? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
All things come of thee, O Lord. Amen. We offer this holy sacrifice to the greater glory of Almighty God in thanksgiving for the passion, death, resurrection, and ascension of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Brethren, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
The Lord receives this sacrifice at thy hands to the praise and glory of his name, both to our benefit and that of all his holy church.
Amen. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's church. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations and to receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and grant that all those who to confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also so to direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, that they may truly and impartially administer justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, that they may, both by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate. Ye who do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbors and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort and make your humble confession unto Almighty God, devoutly kneeling. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed by thought, word, and deed against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. The burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, for thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Hear what comfortable words our Savior Christ hath to all who truly turn to him. Come unto me, all ye that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul saith. This is a true saying and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John saith. If any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God.
It is
very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Let us pray. All glory be to thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for that thou of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there, by his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that, his precious death and sacrifice, until his coming again. For in the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he brake it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink ye all of this. For this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me. Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, we thy humble servants do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty, with these thy holy gifts which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify, with thy word and Holy Spirit, these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us, and we in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray now as our Savior Christ hath taught us. We are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Deliver us, we beseech thee, O Lord, from all evils, past, present, and to come. And at the intercession of all thy saints, grant peace favorably in our day, that we may be with thee this day through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, ever one God, world without end. The peace of the Lord be always with you. O Lamb of God that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God that takest away the sins of the world, grant us thy peace. O Lord Jesus Christ, who said to thine apostles, Peace I leave with you, my peace I give unto you, regard not my sins, but the faith of thy church, and grant to it that peace and unity which is according to thy will, who livest and reignest with one God, world without end. Amen. 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 We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen. I receive the bread of heaven, call upon the name of the Lord, in whom is my strength and my salvation. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come out of my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him that taketh away the sins of the world. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in the remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in the remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be upon you this day and always. Amen. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in the remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost vouchsafe to feed us who have duly received these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom by the merits of his most precious death and passion. And we humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
With thy spirit.
Depart in peace.
The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The beginning of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. The same came for a witness to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle, be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl through the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Lord be with you. Let us pray. Praise, bless, and adored be our Lord Jesus Christ on his most glorious throne in heaven, in the most holy sacrament of the altar, and in the hearts of his faith-filled people. May the souls of the faithful departed to the mercies of God rest in peace. Amen. Good stuff. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Amen. Amen. We thank you for finding us here this Sunday at St. Luke's Church in Sedona, Arizona. We do live streams just about every single Sunday throughout the church year. We will have a special Mass, which will also be streamed on Christmas Eve, beginning at 5 o'clock in the evening in Arizona. So we'd like to have you be able to come and hear us and see us and worship with us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.